Hello everyone, this is Ashish. This is another video on declaration and payment of dividend. Now in this video we will discuss about the interim dividend. Section is 123 clause 3. Now in the earlier video I have already a separate video on the difference between the interim dividend and final dividend. But in this video we will talk about only the interim dividend. Now, what is interim dividend? We have already discussed the definition of interim dividend, or you can say the meaning of interim dividend. We have discussed in section 235, which says what is interim dividend. Now what is interim dividend? It can declare out of surplus and out of profit of current year in which dividend is sought to be declared. See, we have already discussed in depth very well that what is the objective behind for the company to declare interim dividend. Now, as the word suggests, indicate interim. Interim means that is in the middle of the year, we can say in the middle. That means the company is going to declare dividend between the two AGMs. Okay. And the question is, what rate should be there to declare dividend? So for this, we need to see the profit. Which profit? Current year profit. That means, for example, let's take an example. Suppose company declared dividend on September 2020. For 2020, for current year profit on the basis of first quarter, means if any company made a huge amount of profit in the first quarter. Okay, I am just taking a hypothetical example that if any company made a huge amount of profit in the current year, or you can say in the first quarter of current year, then company go for interim dividend to make an announcement to all the shareholders that company is doing well, and in future also the company will announce, or can say will declare dividend like this. Okay, so this is the interim dividend. But this is the case of interim dividend. In the case of final dividend, suppose if we take this the same example, suppose the company is going to declare final dividend on September 2020, then the company need to take profit of the previous year. In the last video we have discussed that the company have options to declare dividend. What are those options? Out of current year profit, out of previous year profit, out of both, or any kind of fund which are provided by central government or state government. In the case of interim dividend, the company will take only the current year profit. Okay, but in the case of final dividend, if company is going to declare dividend on September 2020, that means they are going to declare dividend for the previous year 1920. Okay, प्रीवियस ईयर, विच प्रीवियस ईयर 1920, दैट मीन्स कंपनी मेड सम प्रॉफिट इन दिस ईयर, ना कंपनी इज गोइंग टू सम गिविंग बैक टू शेयर होल्डर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिविडेंड. सो इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से लाइक कि इन द फाइनल डिविडेंड द कंपनी डिक्लेयर डिविडेंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस प्रॉफिट, एंड इन द केस ऑफ इंटरिम डिविडेंड कंपनी डिक्लेयर डिविडेंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ करंट ईयर प्रॉफिट. ओके, नाउ आफ्टर सच एन अनाउंसमेंट कंपनी डिपॉजिट सच अमाउंट इन अ सेपरेट बैंक इन स्केड्यूल बैंक इन 5 days, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द अर्लियर वीडियो ऑफ लाइक वी हैव सीन ऑन द टाइम लाइन. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन वेरी वेल द टाइम लाइन. सो आई हैव जस्ट कॉपीड दैट पॉइंट फ्रॉम दिस वीडियो दैट कंपनी नीड टू डिपॉजिट सच अमाउंट ऑफ डिक्लेरेशन इन अ सेपरेट बैंक अकाउंट इन अ स्केड्यूल बैंक इन 5 days. ओके, नाउ देर आर सम कंडीशंस फॉर द कंपनी टू डिक्लेयर डिविडेंड. वट आर दोज? इफ कंपनी इंकर्ड एनी लॉस ड्यूरिंग द करंट ईयर प्रॉफिट अप टू द एंड ऑफ क्वार्टर इमीजिएटली प्रीसीडिंग द डेट ऑफ डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ इंटरिम डिविडेंड, देन रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड शुड बी एवरेज ऑफ 3 इमीजिएटली प्रीसीडिंग ईयर. What does it mean? Suppose a company is going to declare dividend on September 2020, which dividend? Interim dividend. And the company having loss in the end of preceding quarter, that is first quarter, then take average of 3 immediately preceding years. I repeat. If a company is going to declare interim dividend on September 2020 and the company have already incurred loss at the end of preceding quarter, that is on the first quarter, then the company need to take average of 3 immediately preceding years. Okay, so the here question is, if the company already incurred loss for the current year, then what will be the rate of dividend for the interim dividend? Okay, so what will be the rate? The rate will be the average of 3 preceding years. It should not be more than this. Okay, now the next point is payment of dividend, that we will cover in section 123.5. It tells about the 2 points. That means how the company will going to make payment to shareholders. Okay, and the second point is to whom is going to make payment. So first we will discuss about how. So what are the options for the company to make payment for the dividend? First one is cash, warrant. Warrant in the sense that suppose if I am a shareholder of X company, so and if I want to receive any kind of dividend which our company already declared, so I will go with warrant. That means some kind of slip to the company. I will go with the slip, and on the basis of that slip, the company will make payment of dividend in my account. Okay. So the company have option of cash, warrant, check. But check here means no post dated. For example, if company issued a check for like the company will make payment to X person after 30 days. Okay, but this will check will not work here. So no post dated check will not be issued to shareholders. Okay. Now company make payment by any letter mode, or you can say they may use NAP. Okay. Now to whom the company is going to make payment of dividend? To registered shareholders, obviously. Okay. Or you can say if any shareholder want to transfer the share to any other person, then that shareholder कैन गिव ऑर्डर, कैन गिव ऑर्डर और कैन गिव द बैंकर नेम टू ट्रांसफर द शेयर टू अनदर अनदर पर्सन. ओके सो दीज आर द ऑप्शंस अवेलेबल फॉर द मेकिंग पेमेंट ऑफ डिविडेंड नाउ. बट दीज ऑप्शंस और यू कैन से दिस सेक्शन इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल इन द केस ऑफ निधि कंपनी. वट इज निधि कंपनी इज एक्चुअली इट इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ बेसिकली अ म्यूचुअल बेनिफिट कंपनी हु ट्रांजेक्ट्स ओनली विद इट्स मेंबर्स. दैट मीन्स सपोज इफ एनी कंपनी हैव 50 मेंबर्स दे म्यूचुअली डिसाइड वेयर दे विल इन्वेस्ट देयर मनी टू सपोज द एक्स कंपनी और सपोज दे आर इन फाइनेंसिंग इन फील्ड सो दे विल बी एक्चुअली फाइनेंस और गिविंग लोन टू एक्स कंपनीज. सो दे ऑल म्यूचुअली डिसाइड सो वट एवर द कंपनी अर्न दे विल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड एज पर देयर राइट्स और एज पर देयर रेशोज. सो निधि कंपनी हेयर इज अ शेयर होल्डर ऑफ ऑफ एन एक्स कंपनी हु डिक्लेयर डिविडेंड. इफ नॉट क्लेम इन 30 डेज देन इट इज नॉट टू बी ट्रांसफर टू अनपेड अकाउंट रेदर क्रेडिट टू मेंबर्स अकाउंट. विच मीन्स इन द केस ऑफ निधि कंपनी इन द केस ऑफ निधि कंपनी एंड हु एंड हु इज निधि कंपनी हेयर इट इज बेसिकली अ शेयर होल्डर. ओके now suppose there is x company who declare dividend for the nidhi company. So who will claim the declared who will claim this dividend? Either member or company. Suppose if the company not able to claim those dividend in within 30 days then those shares or sorry those dividend will be transferred to its members. Okay now the next section is 123(6) that is prohibition of declaration. That means if company fails or you can say anything if any make fails to comply with any condition then what are the default process. So if a company fails to comply with the conditions of section 73 and 74 shall not so long as failure continues declare any dividend on its equity shares. That means if the company failed to fulfill all the condition of section 73 and 74 then they will not be able to declare dividend for the equity shareholders. Now what is section 73 and 74? Section 73 tells about the guidelines or you can say some rules regarding the acceptance of dividend acceptance of deposits from public and 74 repayment of deposits. So if the company fail to fulfill all these conditions of 73 and 74 then they will not longer to declare dividend for the equity shareholders. That means they can declare dividend to preference share capital. Okay so for the preference share capital this the section 73 and section 74 is not applicable. Okay now next one is section 8 companies. Again it is this section is not applicable for the section 8 companies. Now what are section 8 companies? These are basically NGOs, not for profit organization. That means those companies who are incorporated for promoting the objective of the company. Suppose if these companies are having some profit then they will not distribute those profit to their members or you can say to the shareholders. They actually utilize those profit in their business model. Okay, for promoting their objective. Okay, so this is the all about the in this video we have discussed interim dividend. That means what are the conditions for the company to declare interim dividend. Then we have discussed about the payment of dividend. in section 123.5. Things come here. Many options to make payment to registered shareholders. What are those? Cash, check, letter mode, or in kind. Okay. Then the payment of dividend is not for the nifty company. Okay. Then we have discussed the prohibition of declaration. That means if company fail to comply with section 73 and 74, then they will not longer to declare dividend for the equity shareholders. Okay. I hope you have understood this very well. Thank you.